Hey guys, welcome back to another video in the series of DevOps project, and this is project 2 that we are discussing about. So in the last video we discussed about these two things, which is the DB, the database, MySQL, and then we talked about Memcache VM. Okay, so these are the two things that we talked about. Now we are going to talk about RabbitMQ, Tomcat, and the Nginx, which is our web server. Okay, so let's start from the RabbitMQ. So you already know that the name is there, RMQ01, and it is going to use the CentOS 7. The name of the host would be RMQ01, the private network. This is the IP that it is going to be using. After that, the provision would be shell, and then we are going to use the rabbitmq.sh file. So this is the rabbitmq.sh file. What we are going to do it, we are going to use shebang bin bash. I hope I have told you that what is the meaning of this shebang in the last video. I hope you guys have done it and understood what is the meaning and why do we use it. If not, please feel free to go to Google and then Google about it. Okay, so the commands that we are going to use it in the sh file is sudo yum install epl release, which we did manually in the first project. After that, we are going to update it. You know already that hyphen y is used for that. I don't want to have prompts for it. After that, I'm going to install the wget widget because I'm going to make a call to this erlang solution no arch rpm package. That's why I need wget, so that's why I'm installing wget over here. Okay, once we get this erlang package, I'll be doing sudo rpm, I'll be extracting it and then installing this erlang using socat. After that, if you're confused that what is this, you can go to the first project that I've talked about and I have explained what is socat is doing over there. Okay, after that, I'm making a curl command hyphen s to this package and then from the repository, and after that I'm installing this rabbitmq server. Okay, once done, I'll start the rabbitmq server. I'll enable, I hope you know what is enable. Enable enables the service in such a way that when you restart the VM, you do not have to restart it every time. Restart the service every time. It would be always started once you restart the server. Okay. And then status, that will check whether the service is running or not. Then you have to echo this using, there is a rabbitmq file. After that, in that file, you have to add a user by the name test and then rabbitmqctl. You have to set user tag as an administrator because we are going to take it everything as an administrator. And then what we are going to do is sudo systemctl restart the rabbitmq server. That's all we are going to do over here. Let's head back to our vagrant file. Now let's talk about the Tomcat VM. So in this Tomcat VM, we are going to host our application, which is app001, and it is again going to use CentOS 7. After that, the name you already know, it's a private network, and there is an IP for this, which is a private network and private IP. The provisioning we are going to use today is shell, and the provider would be our virtual box. Okay, and the file that we are going to use is tomcat.sh, and the memory we are giving 1024. You can increase it if you want, 2048 in terms of 1024 into 1 into 2 into 3. You can increase that if you want. Okay, that's the memory we are going to provide it. Now we are going to talk about the tomcat.sh file. So here is the tomcat.sh file. We'll click over here and these are the things that we have to do. Now what we are going to do over here is Tomcat URL is, this is the one that is going to take care of. And then we have to install Java because it is a Java based product and you need this for building it. Now Maven is used to build the jar file, war file or an ear file. You already know that the artifact that we are going to create in this will use Maven as when you build over it, you use Maven for that. Okay. We are going to go into a temp directory and then wget tom url, which will come from here. Here is a variable that it is defined. You can just remove this or type this, but it's not recommended. The good way to do is this. If you have any doubt about this, you can go to the bash scripting for beginners series in my logic ops lab channel and you will be finding how do we declare this. Okay, after that, tomcat bin jar would be gz would be the file name that is going to be downloaded. We are again defining something over here. We are going to use them in future. You can see that tomcat directory echo ext out cut hyphen d would be used by this. Okay, so that's why we have defined it over here. And then chown r hyphen avzh are the type of command that we are going to use. And then chown r tomcat user local tomcat 8. So we are going to create a folder tomcat 8 in which we are doing this stuff. Now, the thing is, if you are confused like what exactly is happening, so you can Google like what exactly is the meaning of A and then what is the meaning of V, what is the meaning of Z and H, then why do we use them? So you can just Google it out because I don't want you to get confused. So you can take a pause over here. So basically, it's kind of you can say that avzedit is used for your zip files or other files that you want to extract. Okay, so we have to understand that hyphen a is used for as an option is for archive files and folders while synchronization. Hyphen r is used for synchronizing the file in recursive mode. Hyphen v is for verbose output so that you guys can understand. Hyphen b is for keeping the backup during the synchronization. Hyphen z or hyphen z is for compressing and transfer the files. And hyphen progress is for showing the progress. I am using only a, v, z and h over here. Okay, so these are the things that you have to understand. Now we'll go over rm hyphen rf. Rm is for remove, and then we are going to remove the Tomcat service. Hyphen rf is we are forcing it, and then in that we are going to create a file. Okay, so in that file, these are the things we are doing. Cat over here, if you remember, cat is used for the command that whatever there is in a file, it will show you, it will display you. Okay, you can manually do it, but we are doing everything over here in a automated fashion. Okay, so this is the content that we are going to use. The user would be Tomcat, the group would be Tomcat, and then it is going to push this in, this is would be the working directory in the Tomcat 8 folder that we have already created over here. The JRE home and the Java home would be this. JRE is for Java runtime environment and Java home. And then environment Catalina PID, this would be the PID. This is like basic things that you have to understand. You do not have to remember everything because it is not something to be remembered, but you just know how to do it. In the exec start and the exec stop, these are the files that are going to run. Okay, so these are the values that you can give. Install want multi-user agent target. EOT, it is starting from here and then it ends over here. Okay, so after that you have to daemon reload, then start Tomcat, then enable Tomcat. Enable I've already explained. Git clone, we are going to do it this from this. So again, you can make changes over here. Instead of this DevOps HID club, you can make changes and write logic ops lab or anything that your profile says. So how do you see it? Let me explain you how do you see it. So what you can do is, let me just save this file over here. Okay, how do you see it? You have to open the profile over here. Okay, and this is the name that you can pick it up. This is the name. Okay, mine is logic ops lab. You can pick yours. Okay, once this is done, you can push the code into the repository. I'll give you an example. Okay, so you can see that there is one change over here. Send cd v file v profile project mvn install. Mvn install is for maven. Systemctl stop tomcat sleep for 60, and then rm hyphen rf. Then we are going to, in this root, we are going to remove that. We are copying the file, this v profile file. Why this v profile dot war file? War file is a web archive file because it's a web based project. Plus we are using through this mvn install. Now mvn install for the first time can take a lot of time because for the first time it is going to use some kind of plugins, and then it is going to use some kind of dependencies, and these dependencies will be downloaded from the internet. So make sure that you have a good internet connection. Okay, after that, target profile file, we are just renaming it to root.war file, and then system start tomcat, and as soon as you start, this will be deployed. And then cp vagrant application.properties. Yeah, before starting that, make sure that application.properties file is fine. We'll talk about that later. After that, we'll just restart the Tomcat. Okay, I'll show you that I've made the thing over, I've made a change over here. So I'll just check in. I'll just add some message, adding repo name. That's all. Just you can commit from here, and then you have to push it from here. I'll show you like how it is happening over here. So let me just quickly open the web browser. This is a project that I have, and then it's in this project. If you'll go to the local setup, that what we are looking at, and after that I was in vagrant, and then you can go to automated provisioning. After that, the file that we were looking into is tomcat.sh. okay, so now if I go over here in tomcat.sh, you will find that the thing is different over here. Okay, and as soon as I push it over from here, I'm sorry about that, push it from here, I'll just click over here, and then it'll ask me, okay, don't show again. I'll just press okay over here for now, and then it is going to push my changes. Now once this is done, it shows that there is nothing to go. Perfect, just minimize that, and this is DevOps HYD club. Just refresh it, and then you can see that logic ops has appeared over here. This is perfect. So that's how you can make changes quickly through using Visual Studio. Okay, so this is fine, perfect. Yeah, so this is done. Once this is done, let's go back. Oh yeah, we want to talk about application.properties file. So application.properties file is over here, and these are the things that you need to take care of. Okay, so in this application.properties file, we have a JDBC driver class name, which is this, and this is for our JDBC, Java Database Connectivity for MySQL. So this is exactly, this is what you have to do. And then we have to give a JDBC URL to make a connection. So the DB machine that we made in the last, that we talked about in the last video, is the name DB013306, if you remember, is the port that we opened. In that account, we are going to use this Unicode, and then you can take this zero time behavior, convert to null. Admin user that we created, if you remember, if you're not, please go through that video again and see that we created a user known as admin, and then the password was admin123. In the memcache, we talked about MC01 is the hostname, 11211 is the active port that we are going to use, if you remember it. The standby is 1210, and then this is the standby host. Okay, that's what we are using for memcache. For RabbitMQ, we're using RMQ01, which we'll talk about, and then 5672 is the port that we're going to use. Test is something that we discussed just a few minutes back in this video. If you are confused, just go back and then you can take a look. Okay, after that, this is just Elasticsearch configuration. This can be used later. We'll talk about that. Let's go to background file again. If you are confused, just pause the video to understand what exactly is happening. I hope you know what is a JDBC driver and JDBC URL. What would it do? Okay, so just Google about it and you can understand. Let's go to the background file again. Okay, so this is something that we talked about. After that, the last thing would be the Nginx VM. So Nginx VM is the web application server that we are going to use, but we are using Ubuntu over here. Okay, Web01 is the name. The private network that we're going to use is having an IP of 192.168.33.11. Okay, or 11. Shell we are going to use, the file is ending over here. Nginx SH is the shell file that we are using. So let's go over here. First of all, we'll check whether it is using any of the repository. No, so no changes has to be made. Okay, apt update. Apt update is the type of update that we are going to use in Ubuntu, because in CentOS it would be sudo yum update or sudo yum something like that, but here it would be apt install nginx -y is again that we do not need prompt. Cat invest eot vpro app, this is the thing that we are going to use. So the server would be app 001.8080 would be the port, and then server, it is going to listen at 80, the location would be this. Okay, so this is that we are going to put that in a file. Eot is the end of it. Okay, mv, we're going to move that vpro app for this file. And after that, we are going to remove the default one because we do not want any, we want to create our own. And after that, we are going to go inside etc nginx vpro app to sites enable vpro app. So we are going to do that. After that, just one thing, you have to enable the service after starting it and then restart the nginx file. So that's all is for this video in today's session. So we have discussed about what db1 and mc01 in the first one, database in the memcached. After that, in today's video, we talked about RabbitMQ application, which is going to run app 001, and then web 001.01, in which we ran our web application. So I think we have talked about everything. This is on the code part. This is on the shell part or NSH file, which we are going to see. Now, understand it that way, that if you do not understand shell file, if you do not understand shell scripting or bash scripting, you would be able to, it would be difficult for you to understand what exactly is happening in backend, memcache, and nginx, RabbitMQ, Tomcat, and Vagrant file. So this is something that you are not going to understand. Okay, so make sure that you have gone through the course that I talked about in my first video of this DevOps project, which is the second one, that you have gone through and understood it. So I hope you guys have understood everything in this video. If there is an issue, feel free to comment below and we will address that. So thanks guys, and I'll see you in the next one.